Hey everybody. So I just got this notice that Shopify added the ability to place a Facebook pixel a lot easier than it was before. So previously, we had to do a lot of modifying the theme using some custom coding in order to get the pixel installed. But now they've actually got this where you can use it to you just put it in one place, and then apparently they'll take care of the rest for you. So it says with the pixel, you can create custom audiences, focus on custom conversions, and get more specific data with the standard events. So I went through this, and it just talks about like the first step is pretty much removing the old code that you have. So it says there's a few things you have to consider before you start using it on your store. If you want to add it, you need to remove any existing code from your pages. And it says this something like, did you know the old Facebook pixel had custom audience pixel for retargeting customers and conversion pixels? The new pixel combines the two. Yeah, we knew that. If you're using the old pixel, then your custom audience pixel is upgraded to the new one, but your conversions will be phased out by the end of 2016. So they just say before you begin, you basically have to remove the code, and it walks you through how to do it. Just go to themes and then find, click on the edit, the little three dots, and then you look for this code. And delete it and then save your theme file. And then you have to go to your checkout one and remove it from there under additional scripts and content. And then they're telling you to go create your pixel if you don't have one yet under name it, create. And then if you do it yourself, you can install it. But really, all you need is the pixel ID. So, and then they say, did you know you can track standard events when you integrate the pixel into your store? So you go to the next one. They just recently added this, so adding it. So adding your pixel to your Shopify store, you can connect it to your store, and your Facebook account will automatically track data for six standard events: view content, add to cart, initiate checkout, add payment info, purchase, and search. So that's the ones that they're using. I'm trying to see if they have anything on custom conversions, but I do not see it in here yet. So set up the pixel in your Shopify admin. So you just go to online store settings, and then right there, they have a new spot, Facebook pixel account, and that's your ID. Right there. Click save, and then you can verify that it's working. Go to the ads manager. And it doesn't really register in real time like they say, but if you don't have any traffic going, then you're not going to see anything in there. And then you can understand standard events. So view content is like a key page view pixel. Search, add to cart means the actually products added to the cart, so they click on the add to cart button. Initiate checkout is when they enter the checkout flow prior to completing the checkout. So it's like a next step after the add to cart, I guess. Add payment info means they're actually on that page where they're entering their payment info, and then purchase means they actually did it, they bought it. So, my advice right now, if you don't have it installed on the store, you can do it this way easily, and you don't have to worry about any custom coding at all. However, I don't see the custom coding in here for custom conversion events yet. Maybe they're going to come up with that, or they're going to come up with a solution. My solution involves product tags and looking up the product tag, and then using some code inside the shop to make sure that my custom conversions are set up properly, and then I'll set up an event with a content name as the product tag. But it's a little bit more complicated than what they're offering here. But I do think this is a good step in the right direction, and they probably did this because so many people were struggling with setting up the pixel. So have a look. If you haven't, if you're struggling with the new pixel, this is great. But to me, it's still lacking some of the basic functionality. Well, any functionality for custom conversions. If they have that, I don't see it here. But it's a good start, a really good start, and it's enough to get you going. And it saves you having to go in and paste some code and even get somebody to set it up for the add to cart or the view content properly. I just use a simple if statement on mine, but I can see how it could be complicated if you don't, if you're not comfortable doing any coding. So go look there. It's in the docs on Shopify. And then they walk you through exactly how to do it. And if you go to online store settings, and then you'll see that little spot right there for your pixel. Basically, all you do is plunk it in there after you removed all your old code in the theme liquid file and the checkout page. So have a look. Let me know if you have any questions, and have a great day.